My name is Jessica Ching, and this is my fiancé, Matt Fox. So when I first saw Matt, it was at St. John's High School, and we taught two classes away from each other on the third floor.
Our vice principal, he was raving about this new pre-hire that he made, like a spark of energy and enthusiasm, and she was going to be great.
She was kind of like a robot.
Maybe she thought I was a robot because she made me nervous right from the start, and I was a little shy around her. I wanted to be around her and talk to her, but you know, it was tough initially.
So I also remember him being the lead at student council, and he was the only one running it with a bunch of students, and I can see that they all really respected him and liked to be around him.
Well, we got to know each other over the years, and more so at social events, I would say. Yeah, many years I was kind of keeping track of her from a distance, I guess.
That's not creepy at all.
Yeah.
So I think the first time that I kind of thought, you know, like, he's a pretty cool guy was when we were both at a house party, and he was talking about his mom and dad and sister, and I just found it really sweet that he's very close with his family. And for all of you guys who know the Ching family, we're very oddly close.
We'd find ourselves beer pong partners often, and
I would always manipulate the team so that we would be teammates, so that I would have a chance of winning. And
I remember when you'd win, you'd get so excited and you'd just be throwing out the hugs. So I always looked forward to that if we won a game. Well, I don't know, it's just coming into mind
now. Oh my gosh, she loves me.
Well, it's something.
Just kidding.
It doesn't hurt.
Yeah. I think it was only a couple of weeks after we went on our first date, Matt invited me to his weekly Sunday dinner at his parents' house. His mom was very nice, cooked a great meal, and Laura and David really made me feel comfortable just by the way they talk. When we drove home after, Matt turned to me in the car and said, thank you for coming, now I don't have to sit alone on the other side of the table. And I laughed,
yeah.
But I shouldn't.
No, but I think it was a joke. It was a joke.
Oh, was it a joke?
Yeah, it's a joke.
Oh, I thought you were...
It's meaningful, but it's a joke.
I thought I saw a tear. I thought I saw a little tear.
It's a joke.
So I knew Matt had the engagement ring, and it was the summer of 2017, and we had this big trip up to the Yukon, and so me and my girls were like, okay, even my family were like, okay, it's gonna happen here because it's beautiful up there, it's a vacation. So every morning I would hop out of bed, do my hair, do my makeup, and my nails are done. And I'd be like, okay, I'm ready for this big hike. And at one point, Mr. Fox and Matt even said, oh, you look great, but you don't have to be so dressed up, like we're just going into the woods. And so as each day goes by and the big question didn't happen, I was a little sad. And on the last day, we did a big hike up to King's Throne. We're up there and enjoying the view, and I remember eating the sandwich and Matt was like, okay, time to head down now. And I said, aren't you forgetting something? And he checked his pockets. He was like, no, I'm not forgetting anything. So the proposal did not happen in the Yukon as I thought.
In hindsight, and this is to any single guys, if you're going on a trip and you've planned and purchased the ring together and you don't plan on giving it over that trip, maybe just before going, just let her know. It's kind of like,
yeah,
ripping off the band-aid, just get it done. And then the expectations aren't there.
Every year we take an annual hike out in West Hawk.
And I thought it'd be very meaningful to do it at the end of the hike.
We were sitting down and having a bite to eat, and I went down by the lake, and it was really nice, so I called him to come down, and as he was coming down, there was this big bulge in his pocket. Oh, that didn't sound right. In his pants. There was a big bulge.
Unusual in my pants, yeah.
In his pocket. So then he came down and got down on one knee, and as he took the ring out, I've seen so many videos of the rings falling into the lake, and I can hear my mom and my dad's voice, like, move away from the lake, it's gonna fall in. So we moved away, and he popped the big question, and as we were hiking back, I said, oh, you know, it's okay if you didn't ask my parents for permission because because they love you. And he said, oh no, I actually did. And so when we get back, I was ready to go back into Winnipeg and have dinner with his family, but he had packed all of my things. So we had a nice night together, just us two at Tall Pine Lodge. But he did forget my makeup, which...
It's because I think you look beautiful without makeup.
Thank you. So Matt and I would like to thank everyone who's here celebrating our special day with us. Thank you to all the out-of-town guests for traveling to make it here with us, and also our guests that are from Winnipeg. Special thank you to our families who've been with us through this process. Mrs. Fox, couldn't have done this without you. Mom and Dad, thank you. And bridal party, groomsmen, we really appreciate that you're with us through this process.